top predators tend to be suspicious and they're hard to get close to. So, I'm going to be going into underwater stealth mode using this closed circuit rebreather unit, which doesn't give off clouds of bubbles. So in theory, I'm going to be able to get much closer to Barracuda. But this is a trade-off, as rebreather diving is highly technical. Unlike normal scuba diving, this bubble-free system is computer-driven. So if something goes wrong, the result could be catastrophic, unless I take action. But if I'm to get my quarry, then I must go the extra mile, unnoticed.
Just look at that streamlined body and the shape and area of the tail. The Barracuda really is the perfect predator.
I'm wondering if there's some sort of territorial thing going on. They will stand their ground. I think the thing is, this wreck is a piece of prime real estate, and they are sort of defending their interests to it.
Suddenly, it heads off into open water, which is when I spot them massing above me.
There is just a stack of barracuda here at about 30 feet. Lots of fish, good-sized fish.
Perhaps they're gathering to protect themselves from a larger predator that I've not seen.
I'm now actually holding formation with a squadron of barracuda.
Suddenly, I'm surrounded by thousands of razor-sharp teeth. They move off, and I return to the surface. I head back down with a bucket of bait to draw in the fish that barracuda eat. And start chumming the water, wondering what is lurking out there.
Vibration and movement in the water. It's definitely calling in the predators.
But not just the predators I'm after.
Straight out of my blind spot, that one. Straight out of my blind spot. Wasn't really paying attention. Stingray trying to knock over the bucket. Just can't help but see, you know, it seems fairly tame. Mostly interested in food, but that's a very long spine. It's got halfway down its tail.
The stingray's spine carries potent venom, and although rays don't generally attack, they will defend themselves if they feel threatened. They do that by whipping up their tail and stabbing with that spine. The injuries are said to be agonizing, and in extreme cases, have resulted in death.
One thing I really don't want to do is accidentally kneel on the stingray while everything else is happening. That can end very badly, particularly in a kneeling position. No telling where it might get you. I can give her the odd little scrap to keep her happy. Christmas Eve. That was my thumb. Stingrays don't have they don't have sharp teeth. They got lots of small teeth, but they've got a very powerful bite. So I just felt.
Then, with my attention elsewhere, a barracuda suddenly appears out of the gloom.
There's one out here. Here's my bait. Here's my rod. Normally I've got a reel and some line. Today I've just got the bait attached to the rod. vigorous waving of the bait seems to get its attention. Here we go. Barracuda definitely coming in. There's definitely a sort of a cautious approach going on.
This fish is wary, assessing the danger before striking.
That came in at a rate of knots. It just locked on and it was coming at speed. Just fearsome, absolutely fearsome, these things. Just a little rain of scales in the water. Really getting an understanding of how they lock on and how they attack. Barracuda, it hits, and it hits straight on. It's not like a sideways movement like you get with some fish, like sharks. Didn't take the bait, it just sliced the end clean off. Whew. I scarcely even saw it.
That's what must have happened to Bill's foot.
For a moment there, I wasn't looking at a fish getting nailed, I was looking at a human foot, and I can absolutely imagine now what must have been going on underneath the water when Bill got attacked. Learned so much about Barracuda.